All right. Welcome. Oh, I see Monica's there. Wonderful. Hi, Monica. I wasn't going to do a post today. Well, I was going to take a week off because I was out of town this week and doing one next week with Ed Kornhauser. But I was like, I was pretty happy. Well, that's an understatement. Pretty happy about this election. So I'm so relieved and joyful. And this was just sort of my way of saying thanks. And hi, Monica. It might be it might be short. I might do 15 or 20 minutes, or I might do an hour. I had some ideas written down, but I was going to do quite a lot of improvisation. I mean, jazz is improvisation, but kind of like improv without a traditional format. But I've got some tunes in mind too, so I think it'll go in and out of some stuff. So anyway, happy rainy Sunday. I'd hope to do this. It's a good day for baking, right, Monica? I'd hope to do this outdoors, but that's not happening right now. It's raining pretty hard and it's really cold. I was actually, my plan was, if it was still raining, I was going to go up to Balboa Park in the, sort of where those E's are, those arcade walkways, and set up in there because I dig the sound in there, but it was just cold outside and I was like, man, these fingers are not going to make it. So, we're here in my little music room. I'm just listening to the rain going crazy outside. And yeah, it's been quite a week for me. My daughter got moved up to Portland, Oregon. I helped her move. That was really fun. Her and her husband moved up there. Not Portland, Beaverton. It's about 15 miles south of Portland. So that was cool. It was beautiful up there. So thanks to anybody who's joining me here. I see I've got a few people on, and I think I'm just going to start and play and make some beautiful bass sounds here. If anybody wants to hear like a whole lot of interesting bass material, go to Deep Tones for Peace, which it's really inspirational. It's a Facebook group. Bassists from all over the world are posting usually solo bass concerts, but you've got people, everybody from Christian McBride to people in like India to Japan, like all over the world. And it's all these bass players, completely different and unique personalities, musical personalities, and I'm sure personalities as individuals as well, expressing themselves on their instrument, and it's absolutely fantastic. So so I'm going to start. I'll probably, let's just start. This may go into a Billy Strayhorn tune called Drawing Room Blues. It's kind of been one of my favorites. And actually, I posted that on the Deep Tones for Peace site last week, of a different version of it. So here we go. Let's see. How's my angle? Yeah, it looks pretty good. Thank you. Thank you. Miss Polly Gillette. And who else did I see? I saw Cecilia is on there. It's nice having my phone this close. When I do my duo shows outdoors, I can't see my phone, so I don't know who's on there. Oh, there's Kevin Tenorelli, my man, with his super talented daughters, Marin and Ava. Just magical young students that take some piano lessons from me. Who else did I see? Cecilia. Oh, somebody asked me how Beaverton was. Yeah, so I went up to Portland to help my daughter and her husband move up there. And boy, what a fun trip that was. I mean, it's a little bit of a drive. It's like 1,000 miles. And it was really fun. I stopped off in Berkeley on the way up and visited the old house, or went by the old house where I lived. And then stayed with my friend Dave Bell, and we used to play together when we were like in our 30s. And it was super cool. He has a recording studio. We went and jammed some tunes. And then I spent election night biting my fingernails and watching the election with he and his wife, who's just absolutely marvelous too. So we did that. And then I drove the rest of the way to Portland. But I had a funny Rob Thorson adventure. Typical, you know, I'm always losing things. And so I left the second morning from Berkeley, or from Richmond, which is just north of Berkeley, and headed up north. And I'm like, okay, I got everything. I got my backpack full of stuff. And I get to this, I think it was a Carquinez Bridge or something, and it said toll bridge. So I'm like, oh, I better get my wallet out. So I start looking for my wallet. Of course, I can't find my wallet. But it didn't matter for the bridge because I didn't have to pay. It was like an automatic photo shoot. But then I'm like tripping. I'm like, well, I got to drive like 700 miles or something like that, and I better find my wallet. So I search the car, search, and I'm freaking out. It's early in the morning, 6 a.m. And so I call my friend Dave where I stayed. I said, Dave, can you look for my wallet? And he looks, he couldn't find it. I said, well, maybe it's at the recording studio. I'll come home, we'll look for it. And so I drove back there. It was only like a 30-minute drive. We looked, couldn't find it. I did another search of the car, went in, did another search of the house, came back and did another search, like a third search of the car, and I really tore it apart this time. And sure enough, it had fallen under this console of my daughter's car, so I was unfamiliar with all the nooks and crannies. It had fallen under this console, the center console, which was really where I should have been focusing on, and I did look under the seats and everything, but I found it, so it was truly a miracle. But anyway, so that's a long story, but Beaverton was great, beautiful. I think it's gonna rain a lot up there, but hopefully that can deal with that. So, I'm gonna do some more music. Ready for that? So yeah, that was Billy Strayhorn's Drawing Room Blues, more or less. It had all sorts of like improvised stuff with it as well, so that's kind of fun, right? There's no fire. It's just the stupid alarm. Yeah.
What a bummer. It's right in the middle of my broadcast. Hold on, everybody. We'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. What a interesting ending to a lovely song. I think I'm gonna start right where I just was and play the melody out because it's so beautiful. Written by Consuelo Velasquez. Ready? Besme Mucho, another one of my favorites with all sorts of little improv. I always like having a tune in mind, but then sort of embellishing it with other things. Let's see, who else jumped on there? I saw Cindy Thorson. Hi, Cindy. Cindy thought the fire alarm was hers for a second. Yeah, we all get a little alarmed. I don't know why that came on. That was really weird. But it was just a battery one, so I'd not plugged into the electricity, so it was super easy to just unscrew it and put it outside. There's no fire. So that's great. So, other things going on, obviously. The reason I did today was because I was very, very overjoyed with the election results. And I'm kind of all about love love. Like compassion and working together in the world, which I think is just of utmost importance. And I felt a major alienation going on between the people within the United States and the relationship to the United States to the world. But I'm not going to turn this into political talk. This is about music. But I feel a tremendous weight off my shoulders, and I'm pleased. So, let's see. Let's do a little...
I got some tunes. I'm going to do... I think I'm going to kind of do a little blues here.
Yeah. Tim Nunex on there. I saw a couple other people. Now I don't remember. I don't see all my... I see messages when they come in, then they disappear. Anyway, I appreciate everybody for checking this out. Anybody know what tune that was? Name that tune. I'll give you a free CD. No, CDs have no value these days. I'll pay you to take all the CDs I have in boxes. How's that? That was by Freddie Hubbard. And it's called... Barry Farrar is going to know. If Barry's still online, Barry would know for sure what tune that was. Come on, Barry. It's by one of your favorite, not by one of your favorite drummers, but it's by a trumpet player and recorded by one of your favorite drummers. Here's the bass line. All right? So I'll give you a minute to think about that. And I don't know. I'm going to do a couple more tunes. I'm really having a good time. Oh yeah, Adam gets it. Adam Wolf, my pianist, the figures, of course a pianist knows that. So that was called Crisis by Freddie Hubbard, one of my all-time favorite composers. Freddie, Wayne, I don't know, there's a lot of great composers, but man, some of those guys in the 60s and 70s were really, really hitting compositionally and of course musically. I mean, Freddie Hubbard pretty much set the standard for everybody. So Adam gets, he's gonna be the winner of all the CDs in my basement, and there's probably about like between 1500 and 2000. So there'll be a U-Haul truck in front of your house tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. Okay? So yeah, unfortunately CD sales have plummeted, especially since nobody's touring at all. So everybody's online. But I'm gonna clean house one of these days. So let's see, I think I'll continue. Maybe I'll do one more, maybe a couple. Oh yeah, there was this beautiful ballad by Horace Silver. I'm a little rusty on it, but I think I'll make it through it, called Peace. And Horace, another just wonderful, wonderful pianist and composer that his heyday was kind of 1950s, 1960s, going strong in the 70s, and he's passed away a little bit ago, but he's an amazing composer. He wrote some great tunes. Song for My Father is probably his most famous, but he's got just so many great, great, great tunes. Anyway, so this is a ballad of his called Peace, which I find is extremely appropriate right now, because I think that's all what we're hoping for in the world. Like, at all times, I think that's what we should be aiming for. So, here's Peace. That was by Horace Silver. called Peace. Okay, I think I'll do, maybe I'll do one more little quickie. Oh, it would be a fun little song. Oh, this is, well, yeah, I think I'll try this. This is called Tempestade. Oh, there's Renee. Hi, Renee. Oh, my gosh. I haven't seen you in so long, Renee. Renee, I was also just up in Oregon, in Portland, and I didn't get to see Johnny, but I helped Virginia move up there, and so I got to experience the whole Beaverton, Portland scene, and thank you, Cecilia, and I know next time I get up there, I'm definitely going to visit Johnny, okay, because nobody gets to see Johnny. And let's see, I'm still deciding exactly what tune I'm going to do. Yeah, I think Tempestade is a really good one. Okay. Okay, this is by Chico Pinheiro. It's in 5-4, in case anybody's counting or if you're playing drums along with me. Keep me honest, right? Thank you.
All right. That was Tempestade by Chico Pinheiro. Played right here in my little music room on my big old bass. 160 years old. Go figure. Hanging in there. And thank you all so much for your support. If you like what you hear and you want to donate, I appreciate that, because obviously nobody's gigging like we used to. I've got a couple cool shows coming up on, let me get the date right. Let's see, today's the 8th. So 8 plus 14, this is 22nd. November 22nd, I'll be doing a show with Charles McPherson. Hey, Grant, all right.
Woo!
I'll be doing a show with Charles McPherson at 12 noon Pacific Standard Time. I'll be posting information about it on Facebook. That's a duo gig with Charles, and he's fantastic. Thank you so much, Cecilia, for your support. I like it a lot, too. And I've got some other things. I play on Tuesdays at Madison. I'm there every week, actually, from 6 to 8. Madison's on Park Boulevard. It's a great little restaurant, and they've got outdoors. It's like socially distanced, and it's an open ceiling, so it's all like COVID friendly. So, I don't know if COVID friendly is the word, COVID safe. Anyway, that's happening, and there's other. And on next Sunday, I'll be doing a duo with Ed Kornhauser. We have a bunch of cool music already that we rehearsed, and then we got rained out a week ago, so we're making up for that, or 2 weeks ago, and so we're gonna make up for that. We're gonna play. And should be fun. So thank you so much, everybody that was on board today. And there's links right below for PayPal and for the other thing, Venmo. And have a wonderful day. And thank you again for being here and being so supportive. My heart goes out to all of you. Have a great day. Bye.